Today I'm going to show you how I record high quality audio from my USB mic into my computer. Let's get started. So you might see that some people have these really impressive audio interfaces on their desktop that they hook up their mic to, so that way they can record it in their computer. I don't use that. I just have a Rode NT USB mini microphone, and I use a USB-C to USB directly into my MacBook Pro laptop. So after it's plugged in, you're gonna go up to your preferences. This is gonna look different on a PC, of course, but just go to your sound settings on your PC, and here is the sound. And you'll see underneath input, I have the Rode NT USB mini selected. And using this input volume, you can make it lower or higher depending on the volume of your voice. So if you're a very loud speaker, you may want to bring this down so it's a little bit more quiet and sensitive. I like to have it a little bit higher, and you can always make adjustments later on. But the key is not to have it peak too much, because then it's going to be distorted and unusable. So the first way to record is using the free app on your computer. If you're on a Mac, you can use the QuickTime Player app. If you're on a PC, you can use the Voice Recorder app. I'm on a Mac, so I'm gonna go up to File once I'm inside of QuickTime Player and just select New Audio Recording. And from here, you can actually see the levels, which is very useful. And from the dropdown here, you can select which microphone you want to use, and then you would just tap record and you would start recording. And then it will save as its own file that you can then import and use in Premiere Pro or Audition or whatever tool you are using to edit that audio with. The second way to record is by using a screen recording app. So for my tutorials, I record myself via my camera, and I also record my screen at the same time to illustrate something that I'm doing in Premiere Pro, for example. So what I end up doing is in the screen recording app that I use, it's called Capto, and most screen recording apps will allow you to choose an external input for your mic. And I choose the Rode NT USB mini as the input. So then I'm recording my screen, and I'm also recording my talking head at the same time. And when I bring it in Premiere Pro, I will then synchronize the on-camera audio with the high-quality Rode, and I will disable the camera audio. So that way I'm just getting the high-quality audio from my USB mic. The third way that you can record is by recording directly into a creative software like Premiere Pro or Audition. So if you're recording a podcast or music or an audiobook, this might be one of the reasons that you record into the creative software. So I'm going to show you how to record into Premiere Pro. But first, if you're new here, my name is Kelsey and I'm the host here of Premiere Gal, and I post weekly video editing tutorials, effects, and audio tutorials to help you become a better creator. So if this video is helping you out so far, be sure to give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe. So we're talking about dialogue in this video, but you might also need music and sound effects for your videos that's YouTube and social media friendly. This is where I recommend Epidemic Sound. In Epidemic Sound, you can actually sign up and get 30 days free using my link below. So there's both a personal and a commercial plan, and the personal will cover your main YouTube channel, social media. So if you run your own YouTube channel like myself, this is the type of plan you would choose. But if you also use music and sound effects for client projects, you'll want to get the commercial plan. But with both plans, you can get 30 days free to trial it out and download as much as you need. But if you decide to get the personal plan, you can use my code GAL50 to get 50% off your first year, which is a great deal. So I highly encourage you to check it out. Also, if you search Premiere Gal, when you go to Epidemic Sound, you'll find my editing essentials playlist. So you can see some great background lo-fi alternative hip-hop tracks that I love to use in my videos, all listed in that playlist. And the last thing about Epidemic is that I'm currently running an editing magic competition with them. If you go to premieregal.com/competitions, you can check out that there's over $2,000 worth of prizes, including a free year subscription to Epidemic Sound. All you have to do is edit a short 15-second video that has one element of magic, and three winners will be selected. All right, so that's all for Epidemic Sound. Now let me show you how to record in Premiere Pro and how I adjust my audio levels so it sounds great. So the first thing you need to do is make sure your audio input is correct. So go up to Premiere Pro, Preferences, Audio Hardware. And for the input, you want to select the Rode NT USB Mini or another USB mic that you're using and press yes, and then press OK. Then we need to make a sequence to record into. So you can click on the negative space here, New Item, Sequence, and you can choose one of the presets. I'll just use DSLR 1080p 24 frames per second. And now you will see that we have a sequence open, and there's also three audio tracks here. So if you want to record a voice to audio track one, for example, just select this little icon here, voice over record. And once you select this, it'll count down from three, and now it's recording. And you can see my audio levels on the right. And if it's way too high and it's peaking, that's when you need to go back into your computer settings and adjust that input level so it's not as hot. Because it's okay if it's a little bit lower than it needs to be, because we can always improve that later on in post-production. So after you're done recording, you're like, okay, I'm done. Then you can just click on the voiceover record again, and it stops. And now you can see we have the recorded audio directly here in Premiere Pro. And over in the project panel, you can see it was saved as a .wav file, which is automatically saved in the folder that your Premiere Pro project is saved in. So it creates a new one called Captured Audio and a folder for the project, and it will save all of the files that you've ever recorded. So you can see I've recorded other files, but then deleted them from the project panel already, but they still exist here, saved as .wav file, which is uncompressed audio, which is fantastic. But what do I do to make the audio sound great? This is where I go up to the Essential Sound panel, and I select Dialogue. The first thing that I do is select Auto Match, to make sure that the loudness is at the correct standard for broadcast. So when I turn off the loudness, you can see how the waveform just drops down a bit. This is what it was when I recorded it direct out of mic, which was still great. But when I select auto match, it just brings it up a bit to make sure it's at the correct standard. There's a few other things you can do with Essential Sound. If there's a little bit of a hum or a background noise, you can check reduce noise. I only use a little bit, like maybe 0.4, just to get rid of any hums from my laptops or fan or anything like that. If you have any echo, you can use reduce reverb. So what if you want to make sure that you can hear your audio with music in the background? So I actually downloaded a track from Epidemic Sound here called Poetic Wax by Dusty Dex. And if I drag and drop this music track onto audio track two, when we play this back, you can hear that the music is too loud. And now it's recording. To lower the music levels, select the music track, go to music. Let me zoom in before I select that so you can see what happens. Auto match. And it just lowers it all down. Right. And if it's way too high and it's peaking, that's when you need to go back into your computer. So we can hear the music and we can hear the voice. If you need to lower the music track even more, just a tad bit, you can use the clip volume down here just to lower this down slightly. Settings and adjust that input level so it's not as hot, because it's okay if it's a little bit lower. So that's how you can mix music with dialogue. If you're interested in learning more about sound mixing, such as how to duck audio behind dialogue, mix in sound effects and ambience, you can watch my full course right up here, or you can sign up for my Super Peer, where I do live courses where I do a deep dive on a topic, and I have one coming up on sound specifically. So you can go to superpeer.com/gal to go check that out and sign up for that course. So that's all for today's video. I hope you found it useful. Don't forget to sign up for a trial of Epidemic Sound and submit to the competition as well, so you have a chance to win some of my favorite editing tools. There's over $2,000 worth of prizes. You can click right over here to watch more audio tutorials on the channel, and you can click on my avatar right here to subscribe to the channel. That's all for today's video, and as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.